Dear St. Andrew students, hope you are staying at home and staying safe. My name is Saksham Singh, your computer teacher. This is the book for class 7th and this is the cover page of your book. Now, see the contents which are available in your books. The first two chapters is for PA 1 and the all 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is for SA 1. So, don't waste your time. Let's start with the first chapter. Computer number system. A set of values used to represent different quantities is known as number system. As you study in your math, there is a number system. Like integers, minus 1, 0, whole number 0, 2. 1, 2, 3 and these prime numbers 1, 2, 3 and these are the and this will combine as the number system. For example, a number system can be used to represent the number of students in a class or a number of viewers watching a certain TV programs, etc. The digital computer represents all kinds of data information in binary numbers. It includes audio, graphics, video, text and numbers. The total number of digits used in a number system is called its base or radix. As I've told you that if any number system like which we'll study later, decimal number system, binary number system, octal number system, hexadecimal number system. If I say that only 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, these digits are to be used. So 0, we can say that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, only 5 digits are used. As you see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, 5. Okay, let's count it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits are used. So 6 is called the base of that number system. Base or we can say that radix of this of any number system. In early days when there were no means of counting, people used to count with the help of fingers, stone, pebbles, sticks, etc. These methods were not adequate and had many limitations. To overcome these limitations, many systems have evolved with time where different symbols and methods of computation have been used. These systems are called number system. A number system is a notation for representing the numbers of a given set by using digits or other symbols. Let us learn about four types of number system. So there are four types of number system which we study in our computer and we call that computer number system. Decimal number system, binary number system, octal number system, hexadecimal number system. The decimal number system is used in general. However, the computers are used binary number system. The octal and hexadecimal number system are used in the computer. As you know that decimal number system, if I say to you 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. With the help of these 10 digits, you can write any of the number of your decimal number system in your maths. Okay, and you can count any number with the help of these. If I said to you there are 45 students in your class, you will choose 4 and 5. Okay, 45. So with the help of these digits 0 to 9, you can represent any number. So first is decimal number system. The decimal number system is the number system that you use in your day-to-day life. As I told you, the decimal number system consists of 10 digits from 0 to 9. These digits can be used to represent any numeric value. The base of decimal number system is 10. How is it 10? I will explain you that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So the total number of digits are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the base of the decimal number system is 10. It is the most widely used number system. The value represented by individual depends on weight and position of the digit. The base of a number system tells you the total number of digits used in that system. Base represents the total number of digits of this of any number system. The base of a number system is placed as a subscript of a number, for example 8, 4, 5, 10. As you see this, Small subscript denotes, that is this, 10, denotes that the decimal number 845 has 10 as the base. Okay. Now, in a number system, the value of a number depends upon its position. This is called a positional value system or positional value notation. The positional value system is a system where a number is defined not only by its digits but also by its position. Each number in this system consists of digits which are located at different positions. The position of first digit towards left side of a decimal point is 0. The position of second digit towards left side of the decimal point is 1. Similarly, the position of first digit towards right side of a decimal point is -1. The position of second digit towards right side of a decimal point is -2, and so on. The value of a number is determined by multiplying the digits with the weight of their position and adding the result. This method is known as expansion method. The rightmost digit of a number has the lowest weight. This digit is called least significant digit. The leftmost digit of a number has the highest value. This digit is called most significant digit. Now let's see an example which we'll discuss there. As you all know, that I write 1, 4, 5 and 6. In your mathematics, you say that this position is 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crore, 10 crore. All of you know that. So this position is 1000, this position is 100, and this position is 10s, and this position is 1s, or we can say units. So let's see, for example, the representation of a decimal 1, 2, 3, 4 along with the position of each digit. The expanded form of 1, 2, 3 is 1000, 200s, 3 tens, and 4 ones. Starting from the right, the first digit is the units or ones position. The next digit is the tens position, then in the hundreds position, and so on. The value of each position of a number system represents the specific power of the base of the number system. A power is the number of times a base is multiplied by itself. It is written to the right of the base as a superscript. The power of a digit at the rightmost and unit position is taken as 0 for the base of a number system. Thereafter, the value of the power increases for each digit. For decimal number system, the position values corresponds to powers of 10. To represent a decimal number, the digit in the unit's position is multiplied by 10 raised to the power 0. The digit in the tens position is multiplied by 10 raised to power 1, and so on. Thus, the number 1, 2, 3 will be represented as. So, as you know that, just like this, 1, 2, 3, and 4 is the number. So, all of you know that this is 1s, 10s, 1000, 10,000. Okay, and this number system has base has 10. All of you know that 10. So when we represent 4's place, that is 1's place, so we write 10 to the power 0. When we represent this 10's position, we will write 10 to the power 1. When we represent 100 position, so 10 to the power 2. And when we write this 1000 position, so we write 10 to the power 3. So now the expanded form, as you see there, the expanded form of 1, 2, 3. So we will write 1 and multiply by 10 to the power 3, because 10 to the power 3 is that it's a position and this is the digit. Okay, plus 2 into 10 ki power 2, plus this is the position and this is the number. 3 into 10 to the power 1, this is the position, that is 10's position, and 3, and 1's position is plus 4 into 10 to the power 0. 10 to the power 0, if any base and has power 0, it is always equals to 1. Remember this. And when any base like this, 10 to the power 1, I repeat itself again. If 10 to the power 0, if I say any base, either 10, 8, 9, 11, 12, any number has to the power, has its power 0. So it is always equals to 1. And when any number or base has power 1, so it is always equal to itself, that is 10. If I say 9 to the power 1, it is 9, or we can say 9 to the power 0, so it is equal to 0. It is equal to 1. So all of you understand that? Now see the 1 into 10 ki power 3, so that is 1000. Now again 2 into 10 ki power 2, 10 ki power 2 is 100, or multiply by 2, it's 200. Now 3 into 10 ki power 10 to the power 1 is 10, and multiply by 3 is 30. Now 10 to the power 0 is 1, and 4 into 1 equals to 4. Now you add this 4 3 2 1, so the number is formed. Now another example, 39.78 will be represented. As you see from point side, it's 9 is ones, 3 is tens, and 1 is 100. So its position is clear. You know that 1 into 10 to the power 2 plus 3 into 10 to the power 1 plus 9 into 10 to the power 0 plus 7 into 10 to the inverse power 1 plus 8 into 10 to the power inverse power 2. So inverse powers means like that, 7 into 10 to the power inverse power 1. So first of all, forget this minus sign. 10 to the power 1 is 10. So inverse it is, so it is called 7 by 10. 7 by 10 is equal to 0.7. And when it is written as 8 into 10 to the power minus 2, 10 to the power minus 2, forget this minus sign. 10 to power 2 is 100. So 8 upon 100. Okay. And 8 upon 100 is 0.08. So add these numbers. As you see, 100 plus 30 plus 9 plus 0.7 plus 0.08 equals to 139.78. Each digit in a binary number is called a bit. 4 bits form a nibble, 8 bits form a byte, 2 bytes form a word, and 2 words form a double word. Okay, now move next part. Next, binary number system. A computer system understands only two states, on and off, which are represented by 1 is for on and 0 is for off. The binary number system uses two digits, 0 and 1. This is why computers use the binary number system. Since the binary number system uses only two digits, the base is 2. For example, the binary number system is, as you see, the number is written there, 101011, base 2, has a 2 as the base. Because it uses only 2 digits, so its base is 2. Now, since the binary number system uses 2 as the base, the positional values of a digit of a binary number correspond to powers of 2. Starting from the right, the first digit is in the units or ones position, therefore the positional value starts from 2 to the power 0. For example, 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, just like in decimal number system. Okay, now conversion of a decimal number system into a binary number system. You can convert a binary number into its equivalent decimal number and a decimal number into its equivalent binary number. So first of all, let's take an example, 25, which is given in your book. 25, that is base 10. You have to convert this into binary number system. Okay, so for doing this, you know that base of binary number system has its 2. So using this division method, 25 divided by 2, All of you know 25 is not divisible by 2, so we will have to choose its one less. 24, it's a digit which is less, and 24 is divisible by 2. So, and 24, it's 2 into 12 equals to 24. So, we write 12 here, and there is a remainder left which is 1. Now, 2, it is divisible, 12, yes, 2, 6 is 12, and the remainder is 0. 2, 3 is 6, remainder is 0. 2, it is divisible, no. 2, 1, and the remainder is 1. So, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, this is the conversion of your decimal number into binary number system. As you see there, 25, then 12, here 1 remainder, then 6, here 0 remainder, 3, 0 remainder, when 2, 1 remainder, and final remainder is 1. Okay, all of you understand by this division method. So now the remainders, as you these are the remainders, and you write from this side, like 1 1 0 0 1 bracket and 2. This is the conversion of your binary number system. As you see there, thus the binary equivalent of decimal number 2510 is 11001. Conversion of a binary number into a decimal number. Okay, now consider this example. Example 2. As you see there, 1010 and 2. Okay, so you know this position is 2 to the power 0, and this is 2 to the power 1, this is 2 to the power 3, and this is 2 to the power 4, and if there is any number over there, you can write 2 to the power 5. All of you know that. Now 1010, so 1 multiply by 2 to the power 3 plus 0 multiply by 2 to the power 2 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1, so sorry, it's 0 multiply by 2 to the power 0. As you see, it is written there. Now 1 into 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 3 is 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8. 1 into 8, 8. Okay, 0, anything multiply by 0, it's 0 plus 0, 8, 0. Now 1 into 2, 2 plus 0. Now 8 plus 0 plus 2 plus 0, it is 10. So this is the conversion of your binary number to decimal, and decimal to binary is by the division method, and from binary to into decimal with the help of this method. Okay, all of you understand. Consider this example, example 4. As you see, there are 1 2 3 4 5 digits. So 2 to the power 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's start with 2 to the power 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. In this, only 4. So we write 2 to the power 3, 2, 1, and 0. Let's do in homework in these two examples. Now, moving forward, octal number system. The octal number system consists of 8 digits only. 8 digits from 0 to 7. So the base of the octal number system is 8. For example, the octal number 12570, base 8. Okay, the positional value of the digits of an octal number system correspond to powers of 8. In decimal 10, binary number system 2, octal number system 8, and all these powers start 8 to the power 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Okay, now
Conversion of an octal number into a decimal number. The steps to convert an octal number into a decimal number are similar to those used in the conversion of a binary number into a decimal number. The only difference is that in the octal number system, each digit is multiplied by 8 raised to the power of its position. As you see, 12570, it is a octal number system. So we want to convert it in decimal number system. So 1 is multiplied by 8 to the power 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 plus 2 into 8 to the power 3 plus 5 into 8 to the power 2 plus 7 into 8 to the power 1 plus 0 into 8 to the power 0. Okay, now as you see, 8 to the power 4 is 4096, 8 to the power 3 is 512, 8 to the power 2 is 64, 8 to the power 1 is 8, 8 to the power 0 equals to 1. So 1 multiply by this, 2 into this, and you add this, and now the decimal equivalent is 5496. All of you understand that? Thus the decimal equivalent of a 12570 is 5496, base to base 10. Now the last one is hexadecimal number system. The hexadecimal number system consists of 16 symbols that include digits and letters. So 16 is the base of the hexadecimal number system. The hexadecimal number system includes 10 digits from 0 to 9 and 6 letters from A to F. The letters represent the decimal numbers where A 10, B 11, C 12, D 13, E 14 and F 15. The value of each position of a hexadecimal number correspond to the power of 16. All of you understand it? This is the power of 16. And from 0 to 9 you can write any number, but after 10 you write A, B for 11, C 12, as you have to remember these values like this. Now conversion of a hexadecimal number into a decimal number. The steps to convert a hexadecimal number into a decimal number are similar to those used in the conversion of a binary number into a decimal number, but each digit here is multiplied by 16 raised to the power of its position. As you see, conversion of 32b into its decimal equivalent. 32b, so first there are three digits, b, 2 and 3. So then 3 is into 16 to the power 2, 2 into 16 to the power 1, b into 16 to the power 0. 3, 16 to the power 2 is 256, 3 into multiply by 256. Now 16 to the power 1, 2 into 16, and b is for 11, 11 into 1. We can add, and 8 double 1 base 10 is the conversion of this. Any number raised to the power 0 is 1. This is the more to know, I will told you. Now, computer arithmetic. As a computer understands only the binary code, the data input by the user is converted into binary code for processing. This process may involve various kinds of arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. on binary numbers. So, all of you know the decimal number system very clearly because it is used in your mathematics. So, when I write 4 plus 6, so you automatically write 10. Okay, now I will write, if I write 2 plus 3 plus 4, so you have to count 2 plus 3 equals to 5 plus 4, 9. You simply write the answer. But how you add 0 plus 0 in binary number system, not in decimal number system? If I write in decimal number system, you simply write 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1, or we do it very quickly. But in binary number system, there is a rule for this. Binary addition. The technique used to add binary number inside the computer is very easy and simple. This is performed in the same way as you perform addition with decimal number. The following table illustrates. So binary addition is for same as you see, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1, or 1 plus 1, 10. While adding 1 plus 1, the output will be 1, 0, where 0 is written under the same column and carry 1 is shifted to the next place as it happens in decimal addition. As I told you, like add 4, 3, 7, 5, 6, 8. So you write 7 plus 8, 15. So you write 5 here and 1 carry there. 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 6, 10, 0, and 1 carry 5 plus 4, 9, and plus 1, 10. So you write this. The last digit you have write it completely, but here these you write the rightmost digit and the leftmost digit is carry to the another. So it is very similar in the binary number system, as you see the example. Now you see compute 1000 plus 111. So you write from there 111 and plus 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1, either no there, it's 1. Okay, you simply compute this. But when there is another example, you see in example 2, 1, 1, 5 times 1, and another is 1, 0, double 1. So you write 1, 1, 0, 1, and you write 0 there. So 1 plus 1, it's 10, or we can say 1, 0. So 0 is written here and 1 is carry. 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 0, and 0 plus 1, 1. So 1 here and 1 carry there. 1 plus 1, 0, and 0 plus 0, 0, 0 there, and 1 carry there. 1 plus 1, 0, and 0 plus 1, 1, and 1 carry there. 1 plus 1, 0, 1. So it is right 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. All of you understand that? If you don't understand that in one time, you can repeat this video and understand. Okay, if you have any problem, then message me. Okay, now binary subtraction. As you see this binary subtraction, the rules given in the table must be followed to perform binary subtraction. 0 minus 0, 0, 1 minus 0, 1, 1 minus 1, 0, and 0 minus 1, 1. The number is borrowed when 1 is subtracted from 0. 1, 0 minus 1. As you see, this 1 1 1 1 and this 1 0 1 0. 1 minus 0, it's 1. 1 minus 1, it's 1 minus 0, it's 1, and 1 minus 1 is 0, and 1 minus 0 is 1, and 1 minus 1 is 0. So all of you understand this example 3. Now moving forward, example 4. As it is 0 minus 1, so 0 minus 1, it is not possible. So you borrowed from there, borrowed there, and borrowed again from there. 10 minus 1, 1, and there is 1. Now again 10 minus, now here 1 is left, okay, 1 minus 1, 0, and 1, and here 1 is automatically 0, 0 minus 0, 0, and 1 minus 0 is 1. Okay, understand this binary subtraction. Now, binary multiplication. The rules for performing multiplication using binary number is same as that of the decimal number. The given table illustrates the multiplication of two binary digits. 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 1, 0, 1 into 0, 0, and 1 into 1, 1. Now as you see there, compute 101 into 11. So first of all, 1 into 1, 1, as you see there, 1, 1, 1, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 0, 0, and 1 into 1, 1. and there is a cross for there. Now 1 0 1, now add 1 1 1 1. All of you understand that? Okay, now see the example 6. It is very similar. You have to do it when with yourself. Binary division. Now the method to perform division of two binary is same as that of decimal number. The examples are given as you see this example 7. 110 divided 10. So as you see this example, 10 is divided, so 110 is under this box and 10. So when 10 multiplied by 1, it gives 10. 1 minus 0 1 0 1 minus 1 0. Now again 1 this, and again this 0 written as there. Now again only 1 and 10, its remainder is 0. So it is divided easily and the answer is 11. Quotient and remainder 0. Okay, now see this example 8. Understand yourself what is happen there. Most computer operation use the byte or a multiple of the byte. 16 bits, 24 bits, 32 bits, 64 bits. Keep in mind. So as the chapter is completed, this is the summary of this chapter. This one also. Now in the next video, we will discuss this MCQs, fill-ups, true false, and answer the following questions. And I will give you the PDF or the images of the questions and answers and the MCQs, fill-ups and true false. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.